I am going to present my research work on Chota Sikri Glacier. And my presentation topic is Glacier runoff characteristics of the Chota Sikri Glacier, Chandra Basin, Himachal Pradesh, India. As you know, that glacier is a very sensitive indicator of the climate change. And in front of you, this is the map of Chota Sikri Glacier. This glacier is situated in Lahore Spiti district of Himachal Pradesh state. And the length of this glacier approximately 9 km and its basin area up to the hydrological station approximately 34.7 square kilometer and Chota Sikri Glacier area around 15.7 km. Generally we use discharge measurement carried out with the help of area velocity method. In front of you, this is the this diagram shows the distribution of glacier runoff during different different months in the Chota Sikri Glacier. And from this bar diagram, it is clear that meltwater runoff shows increasing trend from June onward, attained to maximum value in July and August. After that, showed declining trend. And next one is the storage characteristics of discharge, means discharge during the daytime and nighttime. For this study, we delineate the daytime discharge from the separate the daytime and nighttime discharge. In the glacier fed stream, only a portion of meltwater generated every day drained as a runoff from the snow of the glacier same day, and rest of meltwater is stored in subglacier environment. If you see this bar diagram, during the early part of melt period, here the both daytime discharge and nighttime discharge is almost similar. Even though significant melting not take place during the nighttime, but we reported a significant amount of the discharge during the nighttime in the beginning of the melt period. So we can say that the storage characteristics of the meltwater discharge is high during the beginning of melt period, but when the melt period progress, means flow period, here the daytime discharge is higher and nighttime discharge is higher, same like that. So storage characteristics is low during the peak melt period. Why such as the trend found in the beginning of melt period? Because in the lot of seasonal snow cover present over the surface of the glacier in the beginning part of the melt season. Besides this, the strength of subglacier drainage network is also low during the beginning of melt period. So that's why we found the strong storage characteristic during the beginning of melt period. But the peak melt period, the lot of exposed glacier ice present over the surface of the glacier. Besides this, we can say that the storage means strength of subglacier drain network is also high during the peak melt period. So that's why the storage characteristic is low during the peak melt period. And this diagram shows the distribution of discharge during the distribution of the discharge, and here diurnal discharge, and here found the minimal discharge observed during the morning time around 7 to 9 a.m. and maximum discharge during the evening time around 4 to 6 p.m. In glacier environment, there is a time lag between generation of meltwater over the surface of the glacier and its runoff from the snow. If you see in the beginning of melt period, here the maximum temperature over the surface of glacier and maximum runoff, around 6 hour time lag found in this case, and here the during the peak melt period, here the 1 hour. So here the time lag is high during the beginning part of melt period, and low time lag is very low during the peak melt period. Why beginning of melt period? Because in the beginning of melt period, temperature is also low, so melting is also low. Besides this, high storage characteristic found in the beginning of melt period, and also subglacier drainage strength channel of subglacier drainage network is also very weak. So that's why we found the high time lag during the beginning of melt period. Here the in the peak melt period, temperature is high over the surface of the glacier, and also melting is high, so found less time lag. And here from our study found out that shows that there is a strong correlation observed between temperatures and runoff, glacier specific runoff from the Chota Sikri Glacier during our study period. I also correlate some other meteorological parameters, but found out that temperature shows a strong correlation with glacier runoff. So here the distribution, last conclusion, distribution about meltwater runoff shows increasing trend from June onward, attained to maximum between July and August. And storage characteristics is high during the beginning of melt period and low during the end of melt period. High flow period, and minimal discharge observed during the morning time around 6, 7 to 9 a.m. and maximum discharge observed during the evening time around 4 to 6 p.m. The time lag is high during the early part of melt period, and during the peak melt period time lag is low, and the strong observation strong correlation observed between glacier specific discharge and temperature over the surface of Chota Sikri glacier. And this is the my list of publication. I have published approximately 20 papers. Out of 20 papers, 19 on Indian Himalayan glacier and one paper in Antarctica. I am Commonwealth fellow, so I went to University of Bristol. So I did some collaborative work with John and Telling and Tom. So I published, I have one paper on this glacier.